Good morning, guys. I've just woken up, as you can probably tell. It's stage 20 of the Giro d'Italia, and we are here near the start at the hotel, about to go for a run. I'm just going to show you the view that I've woken up to. I'm just going to go for my morning run, which I'm going to take you on. But most importantly, this is a huge day for Welsh cycling and, of course, Geraint Thomas, where we're crossing our fingers that he can hold on to the Maglia Rosa. I'm going to take you on this journey with us today. So, yeah, let's do this.
The town of Arta Terme.
Bellissimo! Just been for the morning run, feeling 10 times better now.
Colleague Rodri Gomez, look at that body. Good run, Rods?
Excellent body. Oh, excellent run, sorry, yeah.
In the car, on the way to stage 20. Daily ritual of listening to the cycling podcast. Top driver, top cameraman, Owen Hughes. And our rock star Pereira in the back. Pereira's just been on the cycling podcast doing the post stage 19 interview with G. He's not showing his face because I can't afford that. But look at these mountains. This is where we are. So we're really close to Austria and unfortunately Slovenia, because we're a bit scared that Roglic is going to have his support crew behind him today, but never mind. We'll let the legs do the talking. See you at the stage, boys. Yes, to it! Just on the gondola now, on our way to the finish. It's approximately about 1,000 meters elevation gain, so gentleman sat next was told this would be about a 3-hour hike, so yeah, we opted for the easy route. Look at those views. Hopefully we'll be coming back to later on happy, and this gentleman unfortunately will be a little bit unhappy. He's travelled with his family this morning. We're only 10k away from the Slovenian border, but yeah, we're gonna have a good day out regardless. Just here on the finish line now. Horrible descent into a really sharp S-bend, and then the last kick at the finish line. The first riders on the road now. Yes, incredible atmosphere up here. See now why the Giro has chosen this as the grand finale, and it's just so close between Roglic and Thomas. I think no one can really guess or foresee what's going to happen today, because it's such a brutal climb, and 26 seconds and 59 seconds to Almeida. It's anyone's game. We're just crossing fingers that G's got the legs today. But yeah, gosh, the riders out on the course now, including Mark Cavendish. But let me just show you what I will be working on today, obviously with S4C cycling commentary, but this is the view that we've got up here. pretty special. So I'm here now as the time nears for Roglic and Geraint Almeida battle. The third wave of riders are about to start. So the drill for this time trial today has been that there's three waves enabling all the riders and the motors to make their way back down the mountain for the next wave of riders to come. But next, we're gonna see Geraint, Roglic and Almeida go for battle. I'm gonna try and find some people so that I can have their favourites on the stage today.
I'm here with Phil Lowe, old friend of mine, going back to the days when he was with Wallace. Anyway, Phil is here with Quickstep Soudal. Phil, who do you reckon is going to come up top after today's TT?
Brit in me says Garen. It's going to be really close though. It's a toss of a coin. I'll go with Garen.
Cool, thanks Phil, lovely to see you mate.
And you.
I'm here with Adam Blythe, working on behalf of Eurosport. So, last big decider today, Adam, who do you reckon is going to come up top?
G, all day long, mate, all day long. He's like, he's got to get into a rhythm on this climb, and G's like, he's just big dogging. He's brilliant at it. He's solid, he's never fallen, and I don't think he will today either.
Thanks, Adam.
Cheers, mate, thank you.
I'm here with Barry Ryan from Cycling News. So it's the stage 20 time trial today where the Magna Rosa could most certainly change hands. Who do you see coming out on top after today's stage in the GC?
I have a feeling that Primoz Roglic might win the stage, but I think on GC, Geraint Thomas, I think has just enough to hang on and bring the big jersey to Rob.
Thank you, Barry. So with the stage 20 on the time trial, with Geraint Thomas, Roglic and Almeida, who do you think is going to be in the Maglia Rosa after today?
Roglic, of course.
Yes. Yeah, Roglic is the first.
Great, thank you.
So I'm up here with my good pal, Peredur Ap Gwynedd.
Hello.
And we just sat here and taking in the moment. It's been an awesome start to the day. There's riders on the course, and obviously we're nervous with Geraint and Roglic, and of course can't forget Almeida, but...
And Stevie Williams.
And Stevie Williams. Stevie Williams from Aberystwyth. It's a massive moment, and I'm just so glad that I'm able to capture it and look back at this video, because I'm going to definitely look back at this day on how privileged I am to be here. So beautiful. And even if you haven't been here and you're not here for the race, just come here anyway, because it's an amazing part of the world. So what I'm going to ask Peredur is, Perry, like I said, it's such an awesome day in our lives really, and in our commentary. 10 years we've been doing it now with S4C, 5 years on the Giro. Obviously nothing's going to come close to G winning the Tour, but this is kind of feeling pretty bloody close.
Yeah, I was there in Paris in 2018 broadcasting when Geraint won the Tour, so it's I kind of know this feeling already, so I didn't really sleep much last night. I was nervous on behalf of Geraint, but today's stage, it's the most crazy difficult time trial I think I've ever seen. I can't remember a time trial as difficult as this one, with 8% at 15.5%. That's just brutal, and it all depends on the legs today. If your legs are just slightly off, you could lose minutes. So Geraint's been looking really, really relaxed and chilled throughout the Giro so far, so hopefully we'll see him win today. But you know, who knows, with the climb this brutal, absolutely anything can happen.
Thanks, Perry.
Oh, and one other thing. I'm really glad it's not raining. It'd be bloody horrible if it was raining up there.
Oh, we've timed it well with the awful weather that we've had. Fred is the guitarist for Pendulum, so if you're into your music, I'll put a link in this video down below to his new album. It's pretty awesome. But anyway, see you in a bit.
Yeah.
So there we go. Primoz Roglic has taken the Maglia Rosa and most likely to win the Giro d'Italia tomorrow, barring any accidents. But yeah, I mean, being here commentating on it with S4C, it's obviously, spirits go down a bit because, we all wanted to enjoy tomorrow with Geraint. I feel gutted for him, but it is cycling and there's massive highs and lows. And we're all the crew over there just getting themselves together while the dust settles here and everyone makes their way home.
All the Slovenians are quite a short journey over the border and down the gondola as we're up on this very high mountain.
But yeah, bit of a long drive now and a transfer to Rome. It's not going to be the same, but we have to move on. Geraint did an awesome ride. What we've got to remember is he came second on the stage. He beat Almeida. He beat some massive hitters. It was just that Roglic has done an outstanding ride there to put 40 seconds into him. It was just something else, to be honest with you. Bike and legs. Top bloke, Roglic. And yeah, you've got to be happy for him and the nation and his little kid. It was awesome to see. Yeah, life goes on. But yeah, what a great Giro d'Italia we've had. And we'll move on to tomorrow, where we'll see G maybe winning the sprint in Rome. But thanks for watching. I'm not sure if I've got anything more to add now. We were going to have some drinks tonight, but we may still do, just to drown our sorrows. Cheers.